Hey folks, it's Jared Manninen from the website TahoeTrailGuide.com. The reason for the big old backpack, oh my god. So I'm out here skiing with Dave again. We're doing pretty much the same route, at least the initial part of it, as my vlog the other day. I think it was vlog 68 here at Carson Pass, the north side, in the direction of Meast Meadow. And we're gonna do an overnight in Meast Meadow. That other day was essentially a reconnaissance, and this is the first time, this is the first time Dave's been wearing a weighted pack and skiing. And if you've skied, cross-country skied with a big heavy backpack, this is approximately 40 pounds. It takes some getting used to. The weight distribution is all off. Everything's pulling you backwards. Yeah, it's a challenge watching him go down. Also, we're in spring conditions, so where this was all breakable crust the other day when we were out earlier in the day, today, bluebird skies, we have slush, we have like really soft stuff, but then there's also the shadows where everything gets crunchy and crusty. So the toggling between the slow slush and the fast crunchy shadow snow, oh my god, it's almost comical, I hate to say it, but we're gonna do an overnight, so I'll probably not talk a whole lot because I don't know how long my batteries are gonna last, but we'll try to get in as much footage as we can. But absolutely beautiful day out. Unfortunately, it feels more like spring skiing, like March, April time frame versus January 29th. So we'll see you in a minute. Essentially, this route is, I don't know, somewhere around 9 miles. And this is the one that I kind of do on an annual basis in the spring as a point-to-point shuttle tour from Carson Pass north over to Big Meadow Trailhead. It's essentially along the PCT until it gets to Meast Meadow. And then we take the TRT and head over to the Big Meadow Trailhead. But we wanted to do an overnight, just get the practice. And I honestly haven't done one in a couple of years, so it's all good. Wanna do one. And this weather is ideal for doing any kind of winter camping because you don't really have to worry about a storm and it's not that cold at night. So in a lot of respects, it's just kind of a little training overnight and more like general cold weather camping than true winter camping. But it's camping nonetheless on snow. All right, what do you think?
I think that it is beautiful. It's fast snow.
Some of these angles that are just slightly out of the sun's reach or don't get much sun each day definitely still have a layer of crust on it. So the downhill turning is challenging. And again, with the weighted pack, even more challenging, but unbelievable. It's just so beautiful and so quiet. This is the quietest that I've experienced Tahoe in a long time. So I'm very grateful that there's not 1,000 planes flying overhead or road noise or whatever, you know. Just the two of us out here making some turns, skiing some miles, enjoying the bluebird skies.
What the f-
gonna make me a little better. You're gonna make me bleep that out, huh?
Dude. It's like full danger zone.
Combat skiing. Well, home sweet home for the night. It's been quite a while since I've pitched anything in the snow before, so it took me a little time, but I think it'll be sufficient for tonight. Even if the wind picks up a little bit, I'll just pull that tarp down over me. But it is so still and quiet, and it's just amazing. It's super cool. Yeah, we're about to cook dinner, and as I started pulling my food out, I realized I better cook soon because I didn't even bother bringing a headlamp tonight. So,
oh,
I know, a little bit rusty. Oh my God, right. It doesn't matter. Ambient light is usually good enough, and I'll probably be in bed in, I don't know, it's like 4:30. I'll probably be in bed in 2 hours from now. So. It's all good, but yeah, just cool stuff. We survived the night. It wasn't that bad either. Although I tossed and turned most of the night, but I think I got enough Z's that I'll be good to go for getting out of here. All right, we're about to step off here for the second leg of this little journey over to the Big Meadow trailhead. I don't know that we had a hard freeze, but it was a freeze nonetheless, and it's pretty fast and firm right now, the snow conditions. So at least through the meadow here and then through the forest, we should be zipping along pretty good. And by the time we reach the Round Lake trail that goes up to Big Meadow, hopefully that snow softens up because it's kind of a steep uphill climb. It's a lot easier to perform when it's softer snow, of course. Quiet again, though. Not many birds, but not much wind either, and not many airplanes, so that's a nice thing when you can get out in the backcountry and just be steeped in its solitude. So
this. Slip, bitches, slip. Come on. Could almost wedge it down from here, but I don't want to risk it.
Yeah.
It's pretty steep.
That'll work too.
There we go.
Jesus Christ.
There we go. That was a little better. It's so hard to stop on this snow, dude.
We made it to Round Lake, not without some extra effort though. There's all kinds of like chutes and gullies on the, my left side here. I don't even know, cardinal south side, I guess. That make it pretty challenging getting over. And instead of going to the left or the right, kind of went right down the middle, and that was not the best plan. But hey, it's called cross country, across the country for a reason. You don't have to stay on one trail. But super technical zone and pretty fun though as a result. Like, it's neat to push yourself a little bit within reason. But we're at Round Lake and we're just gonna be heading up. We got a couple more miles before we get to the Big Meadow trailhead. So I'll sign off for now and share a few more scenes of scenery afterwards. So like, subscribe, comment. Thank you for all your support. I appreciate everything. Take care.
Good skating.
More fun angles. This section that's actually on the Tahoe Rim Trail is just, it's sketchy too. There's just a lot of places where staying on the actual hiking trail is not the most beneficial. So zigzag back and forth and find the safest line you can choose. Almost back to the car, maybe another mile. We'll be hitting a flat zone, the Big Meadow, and then we'll head down to the trailhead from there. All right, folks, the end.